We're actually celebrating our Hispanic Heritage Fiesta. Because National Hispanic Month is September 15th through October 15th. And we've noticed an increase in our Hispanic population. We did this last year, and with all of the numbers increasing, we got such positive feedback. Dr. Jama and Ms. Jones sanctioned it, so we decided to have it again and to eliminate any barriers that can keep our families from coming to visit us and be a part of our community. So some of our stations we have, like we're making salsa, but not only are we using like the Hispanic culture to be a part of that, we're also using our standards. We're using fractions, we're using math, but all to incorporate an all-inclusive environment. So we're making salsa. We also have pastelillos, which is also a very popular Hispanic food. We have authentic Mexican attire, clothes from Mexico. And then the students are practicing doing interviews and also as well as some persuasive writing of why they like something. So we're incorporating our community, our culture, plus our academics. So, and another big popular one is the Zumba. We added that this year because students love to move. So incorporating the fitness and wellness with the dancing and the Latino part of it, it seems to be going very well. We had to increase it because of so many students wanting to participate. We didn't want to lose the hands-on part of it. So what we've done is we were able to get more Spanish speakers here. So we're able to have the whole program, and every station has an English and Spanish speaker to make sure everyone feels included. It's an inclusive environment. And these teachers have been amazing because they went and found people this year as well as myself. So I wish I could take the credit, but it really was a community effort among the fourth and fifth grade teachers.
Hey, 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 hey. Okay, okay.